Welcome to Laquita's Toolbox, where we deliver relevant content in the form of tools that empower entrepreneurs to elevate personally and professionally. Good is only good until greater is envisioned. You know there's another level in you. Here we discuss the tools to get you there. Lean in as Laquita and her guests present you with strategies and insight for unlocking your full potential to realize your boldest dream.
Welcome back to another amazing episode of Laquita's Toolbox. I am your host, Laquita Monley, and I have another great episode for you guys today. Listen, those of you that are returning listeners, you know, get something to write with and something to write on, because today's episode is going to be jam-packed with tools. And we know that pencil and paper do not forget. So you want to make sure you write this down. This is going to be one for the replay, the hashtag replay for sure. Mm-hmm. I have with me in the studio Dr. Cassandra Bradford, and she is a powerhouse. And I'm going to let her introduce herself, because I want to make sure I don't miss out on none of the good stuff that she has done and the highlights and when she's coming to your city and all of those great things. So, but before we jump into the conversation with Dr. Cassandra, I want to take a moment to thank our sponsors at Covenant Press. Covenant Press is a faith-based Christian apparel and accessory shop online where we as believers can shop online to buy clothing and accessories that allow us to wear the message of the love of Jesus Christ. Go out to www.covenant-press.com. Again, that's www.covenant-press.com. Shop until you drop, but don't click off of those pop-ups too quickly, because they contain valuable discount codes. Copy and paste that discount code into the appropriate place at the checkout to receive some major savings on your purchases from Covenant Press. Again, that's www.covenant-press.com. Dr. Cassandra, on this wonderful Wednesday, how are you doing the great state of Texas?
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. I'm still alive to tell the story. So that means I'm above ground and not below. So
hey, that's a beautiful day right there. That's a blessing right there. We on this side of the dirt, y'all.
There you go.
Awesome. Listen, tell the audience, please, give them some more meat and potatoes about who you are and what you do.
So I'm Dr. Cassandra Bradford. I hail from Dallas, Texas. I am a business consultant specializing in minority-owned, woman-owned, and veteran-owned business certifications. We are Genesis Preferred Solutions is a niche business consultancy firm. We are a nationwide certification agency. So we prepare all of those certification documents for you. I'm telling you, you know, it's about 28 to 32 documents you have to submit. So we audit all of those and we submit them to the agencies, several, to make sure that you get approved for your certification so you can do business with the government. That's what I do.
See, I like that word, to prepare it for me. I like those words, prepare it for me, because the process, it can be overwhelming
if you've never done it.
Yes. But we want to make sure that we get those certifications. I was at a networking, not necessarily a networking event. It kind of turned into a networking event on Sunday. It was a vision party for a vision board, and it kind of just morphed into more. And
unfortunately, I like that. I'm gonna write that down. Morph into more. You just never know. You see some on social media. I stole it from here, y'all.
That's all right, though. That's all right. It's gonna make me smile. and it really did. It was a vision board party, hosted by a local law firm, and it was the kickoff to Texas Black Business Week here in Killeen. Mm-hmm. So it was a beautiful thing. But in the conversations we had, of course, certifications came up. And I know I was guilty of it. A lot of us as minority-owned businesses, we think that just because we show up as minorities, or we can put on when you're going to Sam's, and we'll talk about what Sam's is through the conversation. We go into these places and we make our bids, or attempt to make the bids, and you wonder, well, I'm a woman. I'm African American, you know, I'm Hispanic American, I'm Asian American, you know, whatever the case may be, why I'm not getting no love? Or, you know, I show up at these networking events and I don't get the call back, even though I submitted my card. And I was one of those people, and that came up in this conversation. Oh, I'm Black. Oh, I can do that. Oh, I'm a woman. Oh, I can do that. But are you certified? There is a process, and that's what Dr. Cassandra is going to help us with on today, to understand just because you was born that way, it don't automatically qualify you. It qualify you to apply.
Yeah, there you go. There, I like that. Yeah, you know, the government doesn't like trees. That's what I tell people. There is paperwork. When you say government, just think of a ream of paper. Mm. And so the program has been around since 1980s. It was enacted into law with an executive order by President Reagan. And then in 1989, President Reagan added minority-owned business to this whole scheme of things. So being certified minority-owned means, or woman-owned, means that that minority or that woman business owner must own at least 51% of the business, operates the business 51% of the time, you can still work a job, and can prove that you are considered a woman with a birth certificate. Number two, that you are a minority by birth certificate, meaning you were born a Black or African American or Negro, Hispanic, mm-hmm. Asian, Pan-Asian, Indian, or American Indian. So you have to at least have one of those on your birth certificate. And if you don't have it on your birth certificate, they're going to want your mama's birth certificate. No, they're going to want your mom's birth certificate. So, because they have to show ethnicity. So the program, it sounds like they're discriminating against other people, but the program was put into place so that minorities could get their fair share of opportunities, not just from the government, but from Fortune 500 companies that participate as well. So you think about anything Warren Buffett owns, all of the motor manufacturing companies like Toyota and GM, right? Dr. Pepper, Keurig, Walmart, Starbucks, Bank of America. It's a whole bunch of them, y'all. Walgreens. It, you know, any place you want to do business at or with, they probably have a minority program. So.
And we want to make sure that we get access to those minority programs.
There you go.
So, you know, we're going to take a pause for the calls right here, Dr. Cassandra. I want you to go ahead and put your plug in, because they listen to this much of the conversation. I know the curiosity is piqued. I'm not the certification expert, y'all. I'm trying to get some. You want to make sure you contact the certification expert. So, Dr. Cassandra, how can our listeners reach out to you?
So you can call our office at 1-800-718-2425. My staff will answer your questions. If you want to make an appointment with me, just let them know that you want an appointment with me. It all depends on your state. Tells us how many certifications you may qualify for, because we haven't gone through all of them. It's a whole bunch of alphabets here for certifications. We just talked about the qualifying criteria is what we discussed so far.
Right.
But you can call our office 1-800-718-2425, or you can go to genesispreferred.com.
So you broke open a whole different leg of the conversations. I still like the fact that you do it for me. We're gonna talk. I'm gonna probably say that several times throughout the podcast.
Yeah.
That you do it for me. But you're right. Like, so for instance, in my household, I'm African American, I'm a woman. My husband is African American, but my husband is also a 100% disabled veteran, and he's a service connected disabled veteran. Hey. And so let's talk about some of those other alphabets that one could qualify for.
So now that let's talk about veterans, since you brought that up. So if, just like your husband, let's talk about your household, that veteran must own at least 51% of the business and operates the business at least 51% of the time. Again, he can still work for an employer, but we just have to prove that he works for the business at least 51% of the time. And he has a DD-214 and he has a VA disability letter, right? So there are three states that will acknowledge him as a veteran-owned business without going to SBA or SAM.gov. And that's Texas, California, and Florida. So they will acknowledge your certification on certain certifications. I'm going to talk about that in a minute. But they will acknowledge that this is a veteran-owned business. And there are Fortune 500 companies that are veteran-friendly, right? And I'm going to tell you, veterans, you guys are hot. You in the state of Texas and California and Florida, you guys get contract matching 6 times a year where you can sit across the table and say, I'm a veteran. Here's all of my minority woman certifications. And I want a contract because I do, I don't know, information technology or whatever. And they will look through their database and find you an opportunity.
Wow.
As a veteran. Now, the rest of us minorities and women, we can't get it. But veterans, yes, it pays to be a veteran. I own business. I'm telling you, I love veterans. Veterans, y'all get benefits that we don't get. Y'all can, as a veteran-owned business, you get under the Patriot Act, you get $500,000 with a 540 credit score. Y'all get some stuff. So come on, we love these veterans. I'm telling you. Now, can we talk about the different types of certifications?
Yes.
Let's I'm just go taking ahead, over the show, y'all.
That's what over. I got you here for. You are the subject matter expert.
So we talked about minority-owned and woman-owned, but we also have what is called a disadvantaged business certification. Disadvantaged business. And this is in every state, but it's a statewide certification. Means you can be it over the entire state of Texas or your entire state, right? Most states have a regional certifying agency. Like I'm in Dallas, so we have the North Central Texas Regional Certifying Agency. In Austin, they have the South Central Region. In Houston, they have, you know, the South. See what I mean? So in every state, they have a disadvantaged business certification. It's issued by the Department of Transportation. Right. And it's a statewide certification. And I'll tell you, I love being disadvantaged business because I bid all up and down the state of Texas, north and south, east and west. I look for opportunities in Amarillo, El Paso, Houston, Dallas. I don't care. I use my DBE certification to my advantage. And then we have another certification. It's called your historically underutilized business certification. It's your hub. There's only two states that have a hub certification, and that's Texas and North Carolina. And that certification, I love it because this certification sends opportunities in bite-sized pieces based on what your business do or based on your NAICS code, right? We know what our NAICS codes are, our commodity codes.
Let's go ahead and drop that plug for those that might not know what the NAICS code is, because those are powerful.
Is your Northern American Industry Classification System. You just a number with the government. All it is just what your company does, and it assigns it a number. So if you go Google NAICS and you see U.S. Census Bureau, right? In the top left corner, put in one of your job descriptives, like, I don't know, information technology, right? And then you'll see a whole list. I mean, is it, you know, developing software? Is it hardware? Is it web-based? Is it, you pick as many of those NAICS codes that are applicable to your business. Then you go back to the beginning and you put in another descriptive word of what you do, right? Let's say you do cloud-based. So you put in the word cloud-based, drops down some more codes. Yeah, what type of cloud-based? Is it AI, artificial intelligence? Is it whatever? I have 21 of them. Everybody who's listened to this podcast or the United States of America has more than one. So you want to make sure that you know, you got your NAICS code so that we put that there. But your hub certification, I'm telling you, those contracts are easy to get these. Now, I'll tell you the entities that will normally use a hub certification would be any county office, school district, college, or university, and now Amazon. Mm. So, yes. So if you are a HUB certified business and you want to be HUB certified and you're in Texas or North Carolina, only those two states, and you meet those three criteria, you can qualify for a HUB certification. I'm sure I got all of them. Now, we also got airport certifications and all that kind of stuff. And I'll tell you to work with our airports. I would never tell you to start off trying to work with airports because the requirements are very high. You can get certified with airport, but the qualifications to win a contract is really high if you're first starting out. So normally, if you want to do business with any airport in the United States of America, you got to carry $2 million in liability insurance, $2 million in workers' comp, and it's just you and a hot dog cart. So I don't talk a lot about airport certifications because of the requirements, but if you big money and your company is already making big money, you say, girl, we already got that. Show me the contracts with the airport. Then we could talk a little bit later. But we talked about being certified minority owned, woman owned, right? Disadvantaged right. business, HUB, and service disabled veteran and veteran. Those are your usual. Now, we do have a small business certification in every state. It's normally for folks in construction or construction services. So you definitely want to make sure. You said, well, I don't know which one I need, but see, I have all of them. You just never know what I may dive into. Even though my office is considered professional services, right? Mm-hmm. I can still bleed over into construction services because we're also minority business coordinators for those that have construction contracts that said that they must use 40% minority owned subs, and they'll hire a coordinator like our firm to make sure that they are in compliance.
Ah.
So some of my opportunities could bleed over into construction services. So I have a small business, SBE or small business enterprise certification as well. So
see, you've dropped some major knowledge. Listen, I know this has been good so far, and we're not even quite halfway through the podcast. Your little pen and paper should be full. And you might be saying, even if you ride and you listening, and you're like, look, I want to write this down, but I can't. Look, keep your eyes on the road. It's a podcast. So when you get somewhere where you can stop, rewind it to the beginning, sit down comfortably with your cup of tea or your cup of coffee, whatever your beverage of choice is, and take some copious notes as you're listening to this podcast, because Dr. Cassandra has laid out some amazing gems. I mean, you have covered several certifications. We've talked about the benefits of being a veteran. Look, veterans, they come find it for you.
Yeah.
Come on now.
We do the certifications for you, then we find the contract.
All you gotta do is show up.
It's in the show up.
Show up and get the certifications. I'm telling you, this is some life-changing information that we're getting on the podcast today. So guys, you know, the whole point behind the Laquita's Toolbox podcast is this. I endeavor to bring you guys information, bring the listener information, tools, if you will, that can help you grow both personally and professionally. And Dr. Cassandra has laid out, I stopped counting about 20 tools. I used to try to track it in my head through the show. I lost track, y'all. So look, I'm gonna have to replay this to my doggone self, like, and track these tools, because I want to make sure that you guys are getting everything that you need to be successful. So if you are not a follower of Laquita's Toolbox podcast, and this is your first time tuning in, make sure to hit that subscribe button on your favorite podcast listening platform, because you do not want to miss one episode. I release episodes every Tuesday, and you'll get those notifications if you have subscribed. Hit that notification bell and you'll be notified when the new episodes release. And also, I'd love to hear from you. Get in the comment section, leave me a star rating and a review. Those reviews are worth their weight in gold. Your reviews let me know the things that I'm doing well, but most importantly, it lets me know the areas that I need to improve, because I truly endeavor to bring you content that is beneficial and that can help you grow personally and professionally. So leave me a rating, leave me a review, hit that subscribe button, and tune in every week, every Tuesday, to get a new episode of Laquita's Toolbox Podcast. Now, Dr. Cassandra, as if you hadn't already given us enough tools, I'm gonna ask you about some more, because I told you, you said something when we first met, ironically, at a networking event. Mm-hmm. You said something that has just stuck with me, that you teach your clients how to go after the low-hanging fruit. I want you to talk about the low-hanging fruit for a minute, if you will, and why, as small business owners and are those that are just starting, and you're just starting, you're just getting your certification, why is that low-hanging fruit something you don't want to leave on the table?
Because, okay, so I need to say this. So we talked about who has, you know, why you want to be certified. With the government is just a client, y'all. They have the ability to pay your invoice. They're just a customer. That's it. And the government is not running out of money. They can afford to pay your invoice. Now, once you get certified, the next step in the process really is to get registered with every city, county, state, school district, college, university, and Fortune 500 company. That's your next step. And that's where we skip over that part. We go from certification to I want a contract, right? But you have to be registered. And unfortunately, in the state of Texas and some other states, our computers don't talk to each other. Not like California, New York, New Jersey, Florida. Their computer, once you're certified, everybody in that state knows. But in Texas, nobody knows but you, your mama, and that certifying agency. So you still got to get registered. And every one of those cities, counties, and states, they have their own application. It's crazy. So then once you get in their portal and you receive opportunity, it's called an RFP. It means that agency is requesting you to submit a proposal. RFP means request for proposals. They are requesting you to send a proposal as to what you would charge for that opportunity, for that contract, right? It's just like if you know, I came in to see you and I asked for everything and you were a caterer and I want chicken and dressing and macaroni and cheese and all cake and four slices of pie. And I want you to tell me how much you're going to charge me for all of that, right? Right. So there are opportunities out there that you don't have to bid on. That's that low hanging fruit. Mm. So for rule of thumb purposes, anything under $25,000 does not have to be bidded out. Mm. You don't have to bid against anybody. You can walk into that city, county, or state office and ask for it.
That's powerful.
With your capability statement, I take a copy of my certification so they don't have to look it up and verify it. I go in there prepared to leave with an opportunity. And I don't want $1 million contracts. I know we like the million. No, I don't want a $1 million contract because I'm going to have all of this insurance, all of these employees or subcontractors. I want the $25,000 contract. I'm a thousandaire. And the reason why I'm a thousandaire, because I live in North Texas. And in North Texas, we got 26 counties. And if I went to 26 counties and asked for a $25,000 contract, isn't that $650,000 that I didn't have to bid? I didn't have to prepare a bid. I didn't have to write it out. It didn't have to be in the size 12 Arial font. I didn't have to do any of that. I walked in. I used my mouth. I showed them my capability statement that has my NAICS codes, my commodity codes. I had my certification. I walked in and said, what do you have in these NAICS codes that I can leave out of here with today? I came prepared to get this completed today.
Wow. Now, see, that sounds like to me a strategic business plan. And we're going to talk about that. I mean, I know the time is winding down on the podcast, Dr. Cassandra. I might be tap dancing in your inbox talking about, can we do a part two, please? But that is, you said, because I live in Texas, you live in Texas. And as you said, many states, especially the one we live in, our systems don't speak as they should. So while I'm busy notifying all of the people that need to be notified that I exist and I'm certified, the people in my area, I can walk in and say, hey,
you want to make an appointment first.
I want to make an appointment. You know,
you only get like 10 minutes to talk to them. So if you hear how fast I was talking, it's because I'm used to doing this.
Listen, you better have that sound like you better have your pitch ready too.
You better.
Your pitch ready when you get in that door.
But well, you know, Dr. Cheryl Woods calls it hunting. We need to learn how to hunt. And normally women are not hunters. We're relationship builders.
Yes.
Right. But this is called hunting. You're going to go in and kill what you want to eat. So you go in there and you ask for what you want. Now, you're not going to steal it, but you're going to go in there and ask for it because you want them to pay you. So you got to be prepared for that conversation. And we're not used to this type of talking or conversation because we're used to building a relationship. We're not used to hunting. So you got to go in there and hunt for these type of opportunities. Now, if you want to sit back and wait to bid and see if you get the contract, did you win, did you lose?
We can talk about that. I need to be making money while I'm doing that. I want to see how I can do it simultaneously.
Look, I got multiple buckets over here, and it ain't raining through the roof in here, right? But I got, listen, I don't just bid on one contract. I have a whole bunch. Now, if they all hit at the same time, then I'll probably send out an SOS signal on Facebook. Y'all better come and resuscitate.
Somebody come help me.
Because I didn't bid off more than I can chew. But I'll tell you, when you're bidding on contract, you have to go to the pre-bid meeting. Mm-hmm. So let's move from just walking in and ask for them to actually bidding. So on the opportunities, the RFPs that you get, it's probably going to tell you have to attend a pre-bid meeting. You need to go. It's mandatory. If you don't go, I wouldn't bid. Because if there's a change to be made, the only people get a copy of the change are the people that attended the pre-bid meeting. Are you following me?
Wow. So you got to be present to win. That's what that sounds like.
You got to be present to even play.
Come on.
And so when you get there, even if I see Lakita there and I'm like, oh, we do the same thing. She thinks she's better than me. I've been doing this for 50, 11 years. She only be doing it for 50. Stop. Erase that. I want to go and be nice to Lakita. Why? She's number one. She's good at what she do. I'm good at doing the exact same thing. We do the exact same thing. I don't want to be number one. I want her to be number one. I'm number two every day. I put up, this is just not the peace sign. I'm number two. Because if Lakita wins that contract, that RFP, and it's $1 million contract, you need help.
Oh, come on now. That's collaborative.
Would you want help for somebody just as good as her?
Yes.
You don't want some Joe Blow off the street that you heard that could do what you do. You want somebody, yeah, she good, but she ain't as good as me. Well, I'm just almost up there. I'm number two. You want somebody that know how to do the work. Right. That you don't, because you don't have time to micromanage.
Come on.
So I want you to win. Sometimes I bid on contracts and just to lose. I do it intentionally.
Come on, let's talk about it. Let's talk about it because you always got a strategy.
Yeah. Yes. Because if you won that contract, I already talked about it. You're going to need help, right?
Right.
Or I'm going to introduce myself. Hey, congratulations. Or I'm going to send you an email. Congratulations on winning that opportunity. Remember me. I met you at the pre-bid meeting. If you need any help, here's a copy of my capability statement. Let's have coffee. Because if you need help, call me. I'll take a little piece of the pie. But if I still lose, same scenario, I lose. If Lakita can't perform, guess who? They got to call somebody to do the job. They're going to call number two.
Yes, they are.
Yeah. Lakita lied and said she had all this insurance. She ain't have it. Number two, hi. How are you? Yes. I'll be waiting for them phone calls. What? Yes, I can be down to your office in 15 minutes. Let's say 20 because I'm going to stop and do a little jig on the side of the road. Yes, I have won more opportunities because somebody could not perform.
That's
and
real good.
If I lose that contract, I'm going to ask for a debriefing. A debriefing tells me why I lost. I'm not going to assume because they like her because she was wearing a pretty green dress and I was wearing pants and they don't like people that wear pants. You know how we get. Debriefing will tell you why you didn't get it. It could be something like you used the wrong font.
Wow. I
promise you, y'all, this is true stuff.
Wow.
Or you didn't follow the instructions on how to submit your response. They'll tell you put it in a Avery 2.5-inch binder blue. You put it in an Avery 2-inch binder. I'm telling y'all, this is true stuff, right? And what I'm going to ask for after they give me the debriefing, I'm going to ask for the abstract, which is a copy of Lakita's proposal. Ain't this cheating? Yes, I cheat. I've been cheating since geometry, y'all. Oh, I'm sorry. Y'all ain't the Pope. I have been treating, let me tell you something. If I'm going to get a copy of your proposal, because if it's a 1-year contract, guess what comes up again in 8 months? That same bid.
Yes.
I'm going to prepare my proposal just like yours.
Come on.
I got the blueprint now.
Come on now.
I'm a beast now. You better watch out. I'll be just writing proposals in other states and other cities for the same thing. Because if it came out in this city, it's probably in all the other adjacent cities too.
Oh, look at that. I told y'all, she always has a strategy. Listen.
Look, shoot. We ain't gonna, we may have lost the first time. We ain't going to lose the second.
We ain't going to lose again. Come on now. It's like when athletes watch film of their competitors or their losses, and they see what the other team did to win. Now I'm going to go ahead and mimic that, and I'm going to improve that. So basically, that's what you're doing. You're just taking the blueprint of the winner, duplicating it, so you could go, you might have lost it in this city, but you don't want it in the next five. So did you really lose? You
that
did
wasn't
not.
In my city that year.
Come
just
on
wasn't
now.
My city that year. It's that's all. But next
come on,
year,
that's just that perspective. Come on, because you won. You won. I love that.
My daughter says, stop telling people you cheated in geometry. I did.
It's too late now. Can't nobody do nothing.
Girl, look, yeah, girl, I ain't got a doctor since then. Look.
Come on. like I was getting myself together for now.
Look. She said, I'm making her look bad, you know. I'm making her look you cheat in geometry.
Like, tell she wasn't even born you. Yet. It was, no, who knows?
Come
on. Look, this man, I'm telling you, Dr. Cassandra, you have been releasing some powerful tools. Yes, we've learned about the various different types of certifications. We've talked about what the low-hanging fruit is and why we want to get it. You're teaching us how to hunt and be a boss for real. You know, ladies, I hope y'all listening. Brothers, I know y'all that's you were like, okay, that sounds good. I can do that. Brothers, ready. Just at the ready already, like
Dr.
is laying out some cool information. If you are loving the things that you're hearing from this episode of Laquita's Toolbox, you don't want to miss any episodes. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button on your favorite podcast listening platform to make sure that you don't miss any episodes. We drop episodes every Tuesday. And again, thank you so much to our supporters, those supporters that have been following us for years. Without your support, Laquita's Toolbox would not be a thing today. And your continued financial contributions are needed. In the show notes to this show, you will find my Buy Me a Coffee link. For as little as $5 a month, you can support the podcast, and so that viewers like yourself around the world can continue to consume great content that help them grow both personally and professionally. Hit that Buy Me a Coffee link today. Get subscribed to the podcast. We love to have you to be a part of the Laquita's Toolbox community. And as a subscriber with the Buy Me a Coffee, you get some cute freebies and other things that will just be a blessing to you, because you have been a blessing to me. Dr. Cassandra, I cannot let you go, because we've been talking about strategy. That's what I mean. I'm like, I cannot let you go without you giving us, just dip your toe in it a little bit. Just dip our toe in it a little bit. I know you got this 9-week power mentoring program. Yeah. I'm halfway scared, but I'm going to say it anyway, because I like to do stuff when I'm scared. It make me just get on, go ahead and do it. Why is it power mentoring? Like, and there's a wait list, y'all. It's a wait list to get on it. So, you know, that I want to be there. Like, talk to us about your 9-week power mentoring program.
So I'm tough, y'all. I have to put that out there. And I give a lot of homework, and I expect it to be done, because I'll call you out on social media. I believe that if you use 1 hour a day, even if you're working for your employer, if you set aside 1 hour a day to work on your business, that's 7 hours in a week. What can you get accomplished in 7 hours?
Yeah.
So 9 weeks, you give me once a week where we all get together, because we do group mentoring. So you get me that once a week, but you get me twice by yourself. You don't really want me by yourself the first time. But let me tell you what we do. Once you tell me where you're trying to go, whether you're launching a new course or you're launching a book or you're launching a business, you tell me what you're going to, we're going to come up with a strategic plan. I'm like Elvis. Once we come up with a plan, a strategic plan, a sales plan, and a marketing plan, I'm like Elvis. I've left the building. I'm over at point B, right? It's your job to get over to where I am. So what we're going to do is help you create a database, where to find your customers, identify them, and find out how to get them, right? We're going to come up with a whole sales plan, how to sell, because you can't market if you don't know how to sell. And most small businesses, whether you're black, brown, green, or purple, we can do the work, but we don't know how to sell.
Yes.
We're afraid to tell people what we do, how we do it, why does it have value, right? So we're going to talk about a lot about value. And we're going to talk about marketing. But what we do that is so amazing, we have a trademark program called Eco Nation. Mm-hmm. And it's where we all help each other. And I make you sign a contract to say you will, that thou shall help each other, right? And so let's say, Lakita, when we first talk, I said, Lakita, tell me a number between 1 and 12 that you just absolutely love. And you say?
I would say 7.
7, July. The month of July is all about Lakita, you better have all this stuff done. Because by July, we are going to, if you're launching a course, we are going to share it. We're going to attend it. We're going to help you with registration. What do you need help on?
Wow.
Can you imagine 12 to 15 people marketing Lakita in the month of July?
Wow, that's powerful.
Do you mean to tell me you can't grow?
Yeah,
you better have no grow with all this help you got.
Yeah,
and it's mandatory. And if I find out that you're not doing it, you're out. You don't get your money back. This is about how do we help one another. I believe that if you leave a favor in the favor bank, somebody always owes you a favor.
Mm,
so if I'm helping, let me tell you, I got a client, a mentee out of Houston. I pushed her into launching her first live event. I said, okay, she's in Houston, y'all. We got to help her. Somebody said, I'll come and work registration. I'm going to come and work your product table. I'm going to post every day. I'm out of St. Louis, Missouri. I can't get there, but I'm going to post every day for 7 days. I'm going to show up. And then now I found out day before yesterday, I'm emceeing. I'm like, I came not to do that. I was okay. But we have to help each other.
Yes.
We had someone else that created all her flyers and her graphics. So did they do it for free? Yes, because we're going to need a favor from you.
Yes.
She said, hey, let me sew into, this is me sewing into you because I believe in the power of giving.
Amen.
So I'm going to sew into you in July, Lakita, because this is your month. But don't forget, mine is in October. Right?
Right? Right, right.
So you may not can get to Houston, but there is something you can do from your side of town. And that's what Eco Nation is all about. It helps create a whole community of entrepreneurs that's helping one another. Now, do I expect them to do everything they do for free? No, you are volunteering to help.
Mm-hmm.
What that help is, I don't know.
That's
maybe
good.
You're like, well, look, I can't help you with what I do, but I can send somebody to put some lashes on you. That's what I can send some lashes, because you got to be cute on that day because we're going to have a videographer. We don't want
makeup artist on the ready.
So we help each other. It's called Eco Nation. And so we have been doing it this way for the past 2 years. I absolutely love it. I love when we help one another. I believe that, you know, we got to help each other, y'all.
We do. I love that. I mean, you've got 12, 15, 20 people boosting you.
Mm-hmm.
You can't help but to grow. And your message cannot help but to expand and to reach out further than it would reach out with just you alone doing it. Even when you're doing paid marketing, because that organic, being tapped into someone else's audience organically, that means they have put their seal of approval on you that says, yep, I posted it. I shared it. I'm talking about it, whatever they're doing. That means I approve this message. And since their followers know, like, and trust them, they're going to automatically know, like, and trust you. So that just gave you space into 15 to 20 other audiences that perhaps you would not have had an opportunity to show up in. I love Eco Nation. I love Eco Nation. All right. Like, that is amazing.
We love it.
Listen, Dr. Cassandra, I don't even want to stop the conversation. It's like, where is the appropriate place to put the pen in it? It's not one, but we're going to have to put the pen in it because I want you to come back. So we're going to respect your time. Like,
I'll be out in Killeen in March. So hopefully I'll be able to see your smiling face. I will be out in Killeen. I think it's March something. March 15th. It's March 18th. It's during the week. I'll be
it's
in
during
Killeen.
The week. If it's the 18th, I will be here. That 14th and 15th, I'll actually be in Atlanta at an event put on by Career Master Magazine. I'm receiving an award as an emerging leader from that organization. And so I'm excited about that. I was like,
oh. No, it's the 15th. I'll be in Killeen. We're going to be having a think tank. It's going to be over there at 2309 East Central Texas Expressway.
Yes.
And this is really, we'll see again, we're going to help you. Everybody's going to help you because everybody become a strategist. And it's called the Think Tank. And so I'm looking forward to coming to Killeen in March. I'll be in Atlanta next week. I'll be in Killeen in March. I'll be in Chicago in April. And then I'll be getting ready for our infamous run conference in July 15th. Where we will have Dion Rambo out of Los Angeles, California, where this dude talks about the infrastructure bill and how to get those contracts through the infrastructure bill. And we have Lisa Nichols. Everybody knows Lisa Nichols. And absolutely. So I don't want to keep dropping names until I get contracts signed. But this is our 11th year. Man, we have partnered with Pretty Mother Truckers, which keeps the femininity in trucking. As y'all know, yes. Black women between the ages of 21 and 32 are making seven figures as dispatchers and freight brokers, never being behind the wheel of a truck. Wow. We also have a bunch of lowriders. So it's going to be an indoor-outdoor conference. Listen, lowriders make money. I didn't even know how much lowriders make money off their cars for exhibits.
I did not know.
And shows. Oh, girl, I was in a pink 1957 Chevy Chevelle, honey. I said, let me put on. Look, she had white carpet. I took my shoes off. I'm in the rearview mirror putting on pink lipstick, needing somebody to take my picture. Pink did not go with my outfit, but it went with that dog.
It went with that car.
And so, yeah, so we have invited the Hispanic American Business Council. So Black and brown people, we are coming united. We're a business owner. We are the carbon footprint to the U.S. economy. Need to let them know about our strength. If it wasn't for us and our contribution.
Yes.
Black women, we are starting more businesses than any other ethnicity.
Yes.
Any other gender. And yes, so we need to let them know that we are a viable asset to the U.S. government.
Come on.
Okay, I'm sorry. Get me started.
Go ahead. I mean, we are in Black History Month. And Women's History Month is rolling up fast behind us. So go ahead and drop the gems. Let them know. I mean, Black women are at a historical high of creating businesses, as well as at a historical high of being the most educated in our country. We have more Black women that have master's degrees and PhDs than any other group. I'm not just talking about women, but any other group, period. We're owning it out here, and people need to know that and recognize it. Put some respect on that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, because you know we paid a lot of them student loans for this. So listen.
Glory. I think the Supreme Court need to hurry up and rectify this injustice. Because we got this education because y'all said we needed it in order to get the bag. And now y'all trying to talk about, I mean, you know what? Let me not. We're going to talk about that on another day because of my husband's military career, I've been blessed to live in other countries. And I will just say this. If in other countries and other first world nations and second and third world nations, comparable higher education is a fraction of the cost. And I'm going to use the UK as an example because can't nobody argue with the fact that England has as much money and clout as we do. You can go to Oxford. You can go to Cambridge. You can go to a lot of these institutions for less than the money that I'm paying to send my son to Hardin-Simmons University. No shade, no tea to Hardin-Simmons. But why I'm paying more money for that? But see, nobody want to talk about that. They don't want you to understand that we can afford to get the higher education at the fraction of the cost. And everybody is still very well paid. Very well paid.
And what people are not talking about, even though Black women are paying all this money in education, we also spend a lot of money. We wear our wealth on our backs, which is not good as too. So we're spending money at school. We're spending money on red bottoms and purses. We got to change the trajectory of where we're going unless we're gonna crash and burn, y'all.
So and we're also paid less. We have the most education, but we're making significantly less.
60%.
Than the people who have less education than us. Yeah, we got to talk about that. We might ride on into that conversation.
We're going to have to morph into more. We got to do it. We got to do something called morph. You see, girl, you know how to put this on a sticky note? That means it's coming to reality.
Well, we're going to morph into more because this is real talk. Like, we're doing the things that we've been told we need to do in order to achieve the goals that we need to achieve. But why you keep putting more pegs on it? Why you keep taking a peg from under my foot and I'm falling? And I didn't even know I was falling. Mm-hmm. Yeah, come on now. Yeah, we're going to have some good conversation on that, yeah, Dr. Cassandra.
We're going to do that.
We're going to do that. Listen, again, before we go, please give the people your contact information because you want to make sure that you're connected with Dr. Cassandra.
You can reach us at 1-800-718-2425. You can Google Genesis Preferred Solutions. It should come up number one in your Google search. Or you can go to genesispreferred.com. There's also a button when you first get on the homepage is to book an appointment to talk to Dr. Cass. My staff will make sure that they answer whatever questions that you have or get you to on an appointment call with me. You get 15 minutes. So I can't wait to talk to you. I want to hear what your business is doing. I want to hear that you want a contract from a giant client. The government is a giant client and we know how to slay giants, y'all. So
come on. Love it. Love it again, guys. Thank you so much to those of you that are tuned into this episode of Laquita's Toolbox. I appreciate you. We adore you. Thank you again so much for your support, your financial contributions. Keep this show going. So get in the show notes, hit my Buy Me a Coffee link, support the podcast so that viewers like yourself around the world can continue to consume amazing content like today's show. And also hit that like, share and subscribe button. Connect with us on your favorite podcast listening platform. Leave us a star rating and a review. Until next time, I am your host, Laquita Monley. You guys be blessed and have an amazing rest of your day. Take care.